Recall example 3 from module 9.2. We applied the method of the lucky guess to the differential equation dy dt is equal to minus 3y plus 2 e to the minus 3t. And we used a somewhat unusual guess of the form alpha times t times e to the minus 3t. And at the time, I said I would justify this unusual guess. And I can do that now using the method of the magic function. So, as always, let's rewrite the differential equation in the form dy dt plus 3y is equal to 2e to the minus 3t. And now I'll calculate the magic function, mu. That's equal to e to the integral of 3 dt. So we'll just use e to the 3t as our magic function. So now let's multiply both sides of the differential equation by the magic function. And magic function is e to the 3t, so I'll have e to the 3t times dy dt plus, let me put the 3 first, 3e to the 3t times y, and that will be equal to 2e to the 3t times e to the minus 3t. And you can see that the e to the 3t and the e to the minus 3t are going to cancel, and we're just going to be left with a constant 2 on the right-hand side. And because this is the magic function, we've got the left-hand side as the derivative with respect to t of e to the 3t times y. So now what we can do is we can integrate both sides with respect to t. When we integrate the left-hand side with respect to t, we get e to the 3t times y. When we integrate the 2, we get 2t. And at some point, we have to have a k, an arbitrary constant, on one side or the other of the equation. So I'll put it on the right-hand side of the equation, so k can be any constant. And then we end up with a general solution by multiplying through by e to the minus 3t. And so we have our function y of t, which is 2t times e to the minus 3t plus k e to the minus 3t. And you can see that this general solution consists of the general solution of the associated homogeneous equation along with one particular solution of the non-homogeneous equation. If you step back and look at this calculation, you'll see that this cancellation between the e to the 3t and the e to the minus 3t term that resulted in the constant 2 ends up producing the 2t after integrating. And as a result, you end up with a function of the form alpha times t times e to the minus 3t as part of the general solution. And this is what justifies using guesses of the form alpha times t times e to the minus 3t in problems like this one. Now, at this point, I'd like to go back to the mixing problem that we talked about at the beginning of module 9.1. At the time, I promised that we'd be able to solve this by the time we're done the module, and I can do that now using the method of the magic function. Now, let me remind you of the situation. We have a 200-liter tank that initially contains 100 liters of salt water, And that 100 liters of salt water contains 1,000 grams of salt. And then we're supposing that we have salt water that contains 35 grams of salt per liter being pumped into the tank at the rate of 4 liters per minute, while a well-mixed solution leaves the tank at the rate of 2 liters per minute. And when I talked about this problem in Module 9.1, we didn't answer the question, but the question I'd like to answer is how much salt is in the tank when the tank fills up. And in 9.1, we derived the initial value problem that corresponds to this situation. So our differential equation is ds dt is equal to 140 minus s divided by 50 plus t. And our initial condition is S of 0 is 1,000. Before I apply the method of the magic function to solve this initial value problem, let me determine the time at which the tank fills up. And we're talking about a 200-liter tank that initially contains 100 liters of salt water. And then we have salty water entering the tank at 4 liters per minute, while a well-mixed solution leaves the tank at 2 liters per minute. So the net increase is a rate of 2 liters per minute. And we have to have 100 liters added to the tank. And so therefore, the tank will fill up at t is equal to 50 minutes. Now with that information, let's go ahead and solve the initial value problem. And as usual, we're going to take and rewrite the differential equation in the form ds dt plus s over 50 plus t is equal to 140. And in that form, that tells us what the magic function should be. Our mu of t is going to be equal to e to the integral of 1 over 50 plus t dt. And we know that the integral of 1 over 50 plus t dt is the natural logarithm. So we have e to the natural logarithm of 50 plus t. And e and natural logarithm are inverse functions of one another. So our magic function is going to be 50 plus t. So we'll multiply the differential equation by the magic function. So we have 50 plus t times ds dt, and then we multiply 50 plus t times s divided by 50 plus t. We're just going to get s, and then we'll have 50 plus t times 140. So this is going to be our form in which we can solve for the initial value problem. And I need more space, so I've written this formula on the top of the next page already. The only thing that I've done differently is that I've multiplied the 50 plus t out on the right-hand side. So I ended up with a right-hand side of 7,000 plus 140 t. Now, what makes the magic function magic is that this left-hand side is the derivative with respect to t of 50 plus t times s. So now I'm in a situation where I can go ahead and integrate both sides. If I integrate this derivative, I just get 50 plus t times s. And if I integrate on the right-hand side, I get 7,000 t plus 70 t squared plus k, where k is a constant that's determined by the initial value. In fact, why don't we determine what that value of k is right now? Remember, our initial condition was S of 0 is equal to 1,000. So let's take and put in t equals 0 into this equation here. If we put in t equals 0, see on the left-hand side we get 50s, and put in t equals 0, we get the first two terms are 0, and we just get k. So if 50s is equal to k, what we do is we take 1,000 and multiply it by 50, so that tells us that k is equal to 50,000. So our expression now is 50 plus t times s is equal to 7,000 t plus 70 t squared plus 50,000. And now I'll divide through by 50 plus t. I end up with s, which is 7,000 t plus 70 t squared plus 50,000. And I'll divide that by 50 plus t. Now, to finish off the problem, I'm going to use the fact that we calculated just a moment ago that the tank fills up at t equals 50. So what we need to do is calculate s at t equals 50. And when you plug in t equals 50 into this formula, you end up getting 5,750 grams of salt when the tank fills up. Now, at this point, I'd like you to do a mixing problem on your own using this method of the magic function.